called it a game for the ages. It was the game that seemingly would never end. And for those who played in it, coached in it, witnessed it, it was a game they would never forget. Richmond at Delaware, November 10th, 2007. Two powerhouses in CAA football vying for a championship. A then record 5 overtimes, 118 points, and a game both teams thought they had won and lost. The highlights began just before halftime and continued through those 5 agonizing and grueling overtimes. It was 10 years ago, but it might as well have been just 10 days ago to those who experienced the memory of a lifetime.
Second down and 5. Flacco back to throw. Over the middle, intercepted. Seth Williams picks it off. Down the sideline, he's going to go in for a Spider touchdown. Seth Williams picks the pass off. His second interception of the season and returns it for a Spider score. Ward tosses it to the right to Josh Vaughn. Looks to cut it upfield. At the 25, breaks into the clear. 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Josh Vaughn from 30 yards out. Cut to the right, cut to the left, found open daylight, and takes it in for a Spider go-ahead touchdown. Flacco takes the snap, back to throw for the end zone, caught at the 1. He didn't get in. Clock running, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Flacco takes the snap, but the whistle sounded. The Spiders think the game is over and they have won. The Spiders think it's over and they have won, and Flacco didn't get the snap off. Now the officials say touchdown. It's 4th and 9, and now Andrew Howard will be asked to make his longest field goal of the season. Snap back, ball down, kick is up, on the way, and good! Andrew Howard with a clutch field goal has tied the game at 48 and will go to a 3rd overtime. Ward under center. There's the snap. Fakes the handoff to Hightower. Has protection. Lobs it over the middle. Jordan Mitchell's got it for a Spider touchdown. For the 2-point conversion. Shotgun snap to Eric Ward. He backpedals. Throws for the end zone. Grayson is there. He's got it. Kevin Grayson grabs it for the score. The Spiders connect on the 2-point conversion, and we go to a 5th overtime. I formation. Josh Vaughn breaks tackles, and there he goes. Touchdown, Josh Vaughn from 13 yards out has given Richmond the lead. 4th and 9, Spider 24 from the shotgun for the game. Flacco back. Here comes pressure. He scrambles to the right. Abramowitz chases. He throws it up into the end zone. And it's knocked away! And incomplete! Ball game over! Richmond wins 62-56 in a game for the ages!
Will you ever quit?
Hell no! We want some more! We want some more! We want some more!
That was a special game with a special team. And, certainly one of the greatest memories of my coaching career, and that was one of those games when the game was over on the bus ride home. You know, the bus doesn't drive home, it floats home.
As a defensive coordinator, you never like to go to 5 overtimes. You know, as an offensive coordinator, you just keep piling up the yards and the points, and at the end of the day, you feel really good about the numbers. As a defensive coordinator, you're doing everything you can to win, but the numbers are piling up, the points are piling up. You're playing a great quarterback in Joe Flacco. You know, he can, you know, anything could happen during the course of those 5 overtimes. But, you know, fortunately we stepped up and made a play when we had to.
I reminisce it now with my coworkers sometimes when I'm, you know, we're seeing football on TV or seeing overtime games, especially the overtime games. That really what reminds you about that stuff like that. And then when you get together with your teammates at homecoming, things like that, and you reminisce on, you know, all the games you played, that's definitely one for the ages that we definitely always talk about.
To this day, I don't think that was a touchdown. I think they had 13 seconds left and they completed a shallow route that we tackled at like the 2-yard line. And, you know, the clock was running and they never really got set, but he did a quick quarterback sneak. It was a really heads up play. And there was just a lot of confusion, and we thought we had won the game, and then the officials signaled touchdown, and this was in the days that there was no replay, and it was at Delaware, So I had a feeling that wouldn't come out well. So we head to overtime, and you know, again, that was one of those games. We thought we had won it in regulation, and that was a, you know, a knife to the gut, because we really thought we had won the game when we had stopped them on the previous play. I was the head coach, but also the play caller on offense. And, you know, because of that, it just, you know, you're just in the moment. You're just continually making adjustments and calling plays and tweaking things. And, you know, it was just an emotional roller coaster, because, like I said, I thought we had won the game in regulation, and then you think you're going to lose it in the third overtime.
Tell me about that last play.
Well, we flushed him out of the pocket, and I think somebody was bearing down on him pretty good. I can't remember who that was. And then, you know, he threw it up. I can't. They weren't really close to the goal line at that time. It was probably, they were probably on a 24-yard line, because I think it was 4th and 9.
We forced a scramble to his right, and then he took a shot in the end zone, and it just felt like that ball hung in the air forever.
Mike Ireland bats the thing down, and as soon as it hits the ground,
we just erupted.
Richmond wins 62-56 in a game for the ages.
The feeling in the locker room is just, you know, big win like that. It's almost unbelievable. Did we really just go through that long of a game, and did we get that many breaks, and did we make that many great plays?
I just remember just how emotional it was after the game. I mean, kids were hugging each other. The locker room went crazy. It was a really special day to be a Spider, and that was a special year to be a Spider. We had a great group of players, a great coaching staff. You know, Russ Huseman, who's now the head coach at Richmond, was just an incredible defensive coordinator for us. And you know, it was just, that locker room was just one of those moments in time that you'd like to freeze it. It's just that feeling of being exhausted, but finding a way to win, overcoming adversity, and doing it with that collection of players and that staff. You know, even to this day, I get goosebumps thinking about that game and that team and what we accomplished.